Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And I render exposition of the gospel and also Sikhism, Bani, and real Islam. So here I'm rendering exposition of Romans 18, verse 1 onward. Life in the Spirit. Christ Paul, you know, has explained these things very logically and very in a simple manner. But still, you know, unless you are a person of spirit, you can't understand it. These Messianic Jews, they have corrupted the New Testament as well. So they are, where there is spirit, they will say law. Law binds you. Spirit sets you free. So you have to be very careful, you know, when you read the Bible. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because the previous husband, Rabbis, have died in greed, and they have become hypocrite in greed, and the people have become shepherdless, looking for a new bridegroom. For the principle in which you have freedom and not the law. Law bind, you know. God has no laws. Because if God has laws, then he is bound by those laws. God works by grace. He is no flesh, no law. Himself doesn't apply any law to himself. And how can he apply to other people? So laws were in Adam and his priest, Rabbis, not in Christ Jesus. We are royal priests of our royal father. For the principle in which you have freedom and not the law in which you are bound under Rabbis of the spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sins and death, are of reincarnation in works, karma. For God has done what the law weakened by the flesh. So it is stressing, you know, that what God has done, you know, and because the people were weakened by the flesh, mean greed. For the comfort of the flesh, people will cheat other people, become rich. Like that Jewish man who was rich, he said he does everything. How could he be perfect? Jesus told him, how do you become rich? You know, by fleecing the poor. Give the money back to the poor and you are okay. No, but he loved mammon, comfort of the flesh. That's why they cheat people. So then they pulled a long face and went away. Samaritans, they were not greedy. They loved God and his people. So that's why the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he was happy to spend money on him. Where the Jewish people, they were greedy. No, they don't want to spend any money on anything, you know, selfish. For God has done what the law weakened by the flesh, that is greed, could not do, by sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh. He had sinful flesh, and that is why he went for the baptism of John the Baptist. And he lived among us. but no sin committed by him. He, no transgression of the moral laws. He obeyed their moral laws, even fulfilled their moral laws where they were lacking. Because moral laws need oral Torah and the written Torah. Oral Torah knowledge was missing, whereas Jesus had the oral Torah knowledge. So he came to fulfill the law and not to destroy it. By sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh in order that the righteous requirements of the law, oral Torah, which is the oral Torah, you know, the might be fulfilled in us who walk not according to the flesh, in which you have tit-for-tat natural laws, but according to the spirit of love and service to each other, as the Samaritans displayed. You know, the ideal rabbi is described by Jesus in Matthew 13, verse 52, as the owner of the house, which is synagogue, who bringeth from the his treasure house, treasures old and new. The old is the written Torah, and new is the oral Torah. Because if you have no knowledge of the oral Torah, the written Torah could be corrupted by the crook. And when it's corrupted, you know, then you are propagating corrupted laws. So Jesus came to fulfill the law, and where there was corruption, he removed them. He presented the nectar of the law. For example, Jesus said, every plant which my heavenly Father Yahweh, or any plant mean person, that my heavenly Father Yahweh did not plant, who has lost his link with Yahweh in flesh, or in Adam, you know, if we, these Jewish people, they lost their link with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew, he was a Semite. So they can't build their covenant with Abraham in the true outwardly of the flesh. So they are unfaithful to Abraham and anti-Semitic themselves. And they have corrupted the written Torah and the new to mess up. That's why Marcion, who was the first to analyze these things, where he made a Bible, he only had the New Testament, only the Gospel, and no Acts. Acts were corrupted heavily. And I find them very difficult sometimes, you know, to tell the people where the corruptions are. I try to separate them as much as possible. For those who live according to the flesh, set their minds on the things of the flesh, which are things of the flesh that you can see, that Jesus was taken to a high mountain, shown all the kingdoms. Forget about God. I will give you these kingdoms, as Pope has fallen. So these are the things of the flesh, which are land, property, and rule over others. But those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit, such as love, service, and contentment. Things of the in Spirit, you know, you become solitary. So when you become solitary, as you know, sometimes people are discussing something in the university or other, then each student or professor, you know, he contribute to the discussion. They are not just following, they are the contributing to each other. So this is how it is in, we do in spirit, where two or three are gathered together in the name of Jesus. Christ Jesus is among us. So you need to be solitary and capable of analyzing or have discerning intellect. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, as during fighting with each other. But to set the mind on the spirit, that make you solitary, humble, and serving each other, as the Salvation Army people do. They did it during the war, you know, ambulance man is life and peace. For the mind that is set on the flesh, that brings in ego, in which you think you are right and others are wrong, is hostile to God, for it does not submit to God's will and not the law. God doesn't make any law. In the Bible it's written God's law. In God, no law. God has the will. Indeed, it cannot because of the ego. Those who are in the flesh, animal nature, cannot please God. You, however, are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If, in fact, the Spirit of God dwells in you, anyone who does not have the Spirit of God, Christ, or Spirit of God, which means the same thing, because Christ stands for His Word, the discerning intellect, or has no Christ in his heart, that makes him a solitary master of his own destiny, capable of entering into the vineyard of our Father, which has a narrow gate, where the true vine, Christ Jesus, has been planted by our Father, does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead in ego. So when you are humble, you know, you have no, people may beat you, anything, you know, you have no enemy. You have no revenge or nothing like that. It's God's will. Because of sin, the spirit is life. Because of righteousness, if your heart is righteous, you know, then you are in God. And then people may beat you or anything, you don't bother because you stick to your righteousness. If the spirit of him, of our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, dwells in you, he who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies or make you eternal like the Father, which is called resurrection, through his Spirit who dwells in you. In Jesus we have been transformed from the sons of Adam, in which you maintain the extrinsic values. Extrinsic value means that people fear you and you feel, you know, that you are something in this society. That you do by either beating them or as a king, you know, rules over the other. So he is something. In Jesus we serve, you know, opposite. And you are subject to sins and death cycles, to the sons of Most High, the eternal God of Spirit. And we too become like our Father, eternal. So this is a very interesting, but unfortunately this is for people of spirit. Those who are of spirit, they know what I'm talking about. And those who are in flesh, for them it is a nonsense, because they want, if somebody hit them, they want to hit them back and take tooth for tooth. So for them, this is nonsense. So you need to be a person of spirit to appreciate gospel.